Follow after righteousness, goodness, godliness, faith, love, patience, and meekness. Amen. But thou, O man of God, or woman of God. Amen. Go to Titus, next book up, Titus 3. We may have to come back. Titus chapter 3. After 2 Timothy. Titus 3 verse 2. And it says, to speak evil of no man, to be no brawler, but what? Gentle, showing all meekness unto all men. Amen. Some of this, y'all just getting it, huh?
Amen.
All right, one more story before we close. Go to Luke chapter 18. Luke chapter 18. And starting at verse 9. And he spake this parable unto certain which trusted in themselves, that they were righteous and despised others. Here it is. Two men went up into the temple to pray. Oh, Lord. Two men went up into the temple to pray. The one a Pharisee and the other a publican. That word publican means sinner. The Pharisee means self-righteous religious folk with a title. Okay. The Pharisee stood and prayed this with himself. God, I thank thee that I'm not like them, that I'm not as other men, as the extortioner, unjust, adulterer, or even as this publican, or those people down in friendship. I thank you, Lord. I'm not like them folks. Now watch what he does. He starts claiming what he does. He gonna give God his resume. Ready? Verse 12. I fast twice a week. I give my tithes of all that I possess. Now watch this. Here's the publican. And the publican, the sinner, standing afar off, would not even lift up so much as his eyes unto heaven, but smote himself upon his breast, saying, God, be merciful to me, a sinner. See? A sinner. I tell you, this man went down to his house justified rather than the other. For everyone that exalts himself shall be abased, made low. And he that humbles himself shall be what? Exalted. So when you take the place of the low state and believe God for yourself, he will exalt you. How many people you ever seen like that? You know, I've seen people in the church who would do the same thing. They'd be praying. You know what I'm saying? You know, they'll hear people have this self-righteous prayer, give God their resume, and then they'll turn right around and say, God, I don't want to pray like that. You know, don't even make me. Did that make them any different?
No.
Did that make them no different? Even if they say they don't want to be like the Pharisee, they just sounded like the Pharisee.
Mm-hmm.
You need to just be focused on God and your issues. Amen? That man came there, he didn't say, forget him, Lord. He beat himself because he knew. He just knew he wasn't right in God. So he wasn't focused around people around him. Amen? All right. A Pharisee trusted in himself that he was righteous, prayed with himself, thanking God he was better than other people. Note the Pharisee's emphasis on self, exaltation of self, and his failure to see his sins. Now, the publican pleaded for mercy, admitting he was a sinner. Note the conclusion, right? One who exalts self will be abased, and one who humbles himself will be exalted. Humility is the opposite of self-exaltation and self-righteousness. We are all sinners. We have no right to look down on anyone as if we deserve salvation because we are so good and they don't deserve it. We can be more righteous than the Pharisee, but only by humbling ourselves like the publican and calling on God to forgive us. Amen. All right, come on. 5 more minutes here. Proverbs 16. I've got to cover this lab. We're not going to cover the last one, temperance. I guess I'm going to come back one more week, y'all. Amen. Oh, God won't let me off this fruit of the Spirit. Proverbs 16. at verse 18. And it says, pride goeth before what? Destruction. And a haughty spirit before what? Fall. Better is it to be an humble spirit with the lowly than to divide the spoil with the proud. He that handleth a matter wisely shall find good. And whosoever trusteth in who? The Lord. Happy is he. So your faith should be trusting and having confidence in God. Final verse. Go to James chapter 1. And I have to bring this out and then we're going to close it. James chapter 1. Let's read after Hebrews. James chapter 1. James 1. Looking at verse 30 and verse 21. Wherefore lay apart all filthiness and superfluity. We're going to come back to that because I had to find out what the heck that was. All right. Superfluity of the naughtiness and receive with meekness the engrafted word which is able to save your what? Souls. Let's keep going. But be ye doers of the word and not hearers only, deceiving your own selves. For if any be a hearer of the word and not a doer, he is like unto a man beholding his natural face in a glass. For he beholdeth himself and goeth his way and straightway forgetteth what manner of man he was. He done forgot where he came from. Now, watch this superfluity. That's what blew me out. That's an old Greek term. Now watch what it says here. It's residue or what remains. So when you get converted, some of your sin still remains.
Amen.
Hello. You don't become pure immediately. Some of your sin still remains. The wickedness remaining over a Christian from his state prior to conversion. It is used by the Greek to describe excess wax in your ears. And how many of you, now see, I'm going to have to get a little deep real quick and get around. I know when I used to smoke too much crack, first thing I would do is still pick in my ears like this. Oh, nobody in here did that. I would have so much wax build up in my ear. Just a digging. Amen. So that's what he's saying. The sin that remains on you is like a wax build up. See? Get the wax out your ear. Superfluity. It's remaining. But my problem, amen. No, you got it, huh? Amen. Get it out. Now see, don't think it's going to come out overnight. It's hard to get wet. They even tell you don't stick no cotton tubes and none of that stuff down here. So superfluity of filthiness is get the excess sin off your life. Amen. Get the excess sin off your life. Because most folk who got titled and who are walking in self-righteousness and pride and in a title, they still got excess wax in their ears. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. Let us come to a close. Father, we just thank you in the mighty name of Jesus. I thank you for this word, Lord God. I thank you for the time that we had. You wanted to do whatever you needed to do. I thank you for those who are receiving the fruit of the Spirit with love, joy, and peace, long suffering, gentleness, and goodness, and faith, meekness. And next week, we're going to hit temperance. So I just thank you, Lord, and let the house say amen in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Oh,